Hello, this is Paul from debatetheleft.com. Like in most Western countries, in the Netherlands, the world of academia, generally speaking, is very infected with the religion of political correctness. In two of my previous videos, I dissected two studies conducted by some so-called sociologists from the University of Utrecht and some other universities. And these studies turned out to be ideologically driven. One of these studies was very badly constructed, and in the other one, results that didn't match the ideological preferences of the researchers were covered up and not mentioned in the conclusion of the research. But it isn't just the sociology department of the University of Utrecht that has become corrupted in the Netherlands. Like in many other Western countries, university faculties like the ones of philosophy, history, and generally speaking, the humanities are usually corrupted. So lately it has been quite common for so-called professors working within such faculties to come out and make very questionable political statements. For example, a professor from the humanities faculty from the University of Utrecht, again, tweeted the following. This morning in the lecture, we extensively talked about the parallels between anti-Semitism in the 30s of the previous century and anti-Islamism today. Nothing in history is the same, but the process of suspicion towards and exclusion of is definitely the same. And this is quite similar to what this man, Leo Lucassen, who is a professor at the University of Amsterdam and the director of the International Institute of Social History, said in a talk show a few days before that. He compared Geert Wilders to the Nazis and Muslims to Jewish people. So what they're basically saying is as follows. People who were against the Jews in the 30s are equal to people who are critical of Islam in 2017, and Jewish people in Europe in the 30s are equal to members of Islam in Europe in 2017. Let's dissect this nonsense. And let's first look at the Jews in the 30s and then at the members of Islam in 2017. In contrast to the members of Islam in 2017, there were no Jewish terror attacks. The security services all over Europe did not have to increase their number of employees back in the 30s in order to be able to deal with all the Jewish people planning terror attacks on Christmas markets. There also weren't any mass sexual assaults in which Jewish men sexually abused European women or raped underage girls by the thousands. There also were no Jewish terror organizations operating all the way from North Africa to the south of the Philippines. However, with Islam in 2017, all this clearly is the case. Meanwhile, there were no Jewish people in the 30s who were clearly representing a problem to the values that their host societies stood for. There were no studies pointing out that 70% of Jewish people in the 30s thought that their religious laws were more important than the secular laws of the country that they were living in. There were no studies pointing out that 2 out of 3 Jewish people in the UK would not report a terror plot to the police. And Jewish people also were not overrepresented in crime. And again, with Islam in 2017, all this clearly is the case. If you look at Western civilization as a whole, you're probably aware of the fact that the West can be referred to as Greco-Roman Judeo-Christian. The word Islamic is not in it. And this is the case for a reason. In addition, Islamic thought is not based on the Greco-Roman foundation that Western or Judeo-Christian thought is based on. And the importance of this should not be underestimated. Things that are extremely basic for Westerners, such as the division between church and state, or between politics and private life, does not exist in Islam. And lastly, Jewish people in the 30s contributed to society. They were productive, very productive even. And this is very different if you look at members of Islam. So can it be said that the Jewish people in Europe in the 30s are even slightly similar to members of Islam in Europe in 2017? The answer clearly is no. So let's now look at the people who were against the Jews in the 30s and at the people who are critical of Islam and therefore of members of Islam in 2017. And this is where it is obvious that these so-called professors are simply implying the label word tactic as written in my book. They are giving people who are critical towards Islam and Muslim the Nazi label. This is a very common tactic used by what I refer to as members of the religion of political correctness. Again, the comparison does not make much sense. people who were against the Jews in the 30s were either members of a totalitarian political ideology called Nazism, or weren't members of this ideology, but simply believed in conspiracy theories involving Jewish people. If you compare these people to the people who are critical towards Islam and Muslims, and are against mass migration from Islamic countries, you can see that these people are not members of any totalitarian political ideology. They are simply a combination of concerned citizens who are worried about the future of their own children and intuitively feel that something is going in the wrong direction, and people who have taken the time to actually study Islam and have come to the inevitable conclusion that it is a dangerous ideology, which is both religious and political. And also, it is important to note that these concerns are not based on any conspiracy theories, but instead on hard facts. And facts that members of the religion of political correctness, such as these so-called professors, are unwilling to look at, are still facts. Another difference between the people who were against the Jews in the 30s and the people who are critical of Islam in 2017 is that the Nazis and the conspiracy theorists considered the Jewish people to be a race, while members of Islam, or Muslims, are clearly not a race. No matter what your race is, you can literally choose to become a member of Islam. You only have to go to an imam, pronounce some sentence, which is called the Shahada, and you will immediately be a member of Islam. And you can then choose to become an apostate and leave Islam, which is punishable by death according to Islam. So your race or ethnicity is irrelevant here. So let's recap what happened there. University professors from the University of Amsterdam and the University of Utrecht say these type of things. Now, this is a reflection of the poor state of academia in the Western world. Academia originally used to be independent from the mainstream society. When the mainstream society was stuck in some kind of taboo, it was the role of academia to break it. Criticizing Islam is such a taboo, and the role of academics is to break that taboo, because Islam badly needs criticism. But these people are poorly educated and do not know how to engage in critical thinking. They are not rational thinkers, but instead religious thinkers. They have become priests. They are simply spreading the gospel of the religion of political correctness and are unwilling to question this very ideology itself. Their so-called academic thinking only takes place within a very narrow range of what is acceptable thought according to the religion of political correctness. Their ability to think is therefore underdeveloped and has been overruled by mere virtue signaling. It is not about intellectual honesty for these people. It is about being seen as virtuous by other members of the religion of political correctness, and the people who don't agree with them get labeled as being Nazis and racist and xenophobes. And let's go a bit further and dig a bit deeper into the following. People who were against the Jews in the 30s are equal to people who are critical of Islam in 2017. And let's again take a look at this part of this man's tweet. Nothing in history is the same, but the process of suspicion towards and exclusion of is definitely the same. And this actually makes a person wonder, because if you look at the Netherlands and ask yourself honestly, which group gets race suspicion towards, excluded and demonized, even demonized in the mainstream media in the Netherlands? Because there actually is a group in the Netherlands that fits this description. A group that has been excluded and demonized for over 10 years. This is the group of people who have been voting for Geert Wilders. This is the group that gets excluded from participating in forming a coalition, even though the Netherlands is supposed to be a democracy, and demonized, like this man is doing himself right now, by calling people who are critical towards Islam Nazis. If you admit that you voted Geert Wilders, you can even lose your job in the Netherlands. And this social atmosphere is also something that by far most academics in the Netherlands are not talking about, even though this should also be their responsibility as guarders of Western values, including the concept of democracy. Anyway, so these are the type of people who are often in front of a classroom filled with students in the Netherlands, and they are probably having a negative effect on the development of their students. This is Paul from TheBetaLove.com. If you like the content, please subscribe or consider supporting my work through Patreon. And most importantly, never stop debating the left on Islam. Take care.